Welcome back to another week of the Weekly What's Up. Today is Father's Day, so let's get into it. This episode is going to be a little sentimental to me because my dad is the whole reason why I'm even doing this, doing comedy, being an entertainer. I remember growing up, my dad was the funniest person that anybody knew. Anytime he went somewhere, he's always making people laugh, and everybody liked him. And that's, to me, I was like, I want that. I want people to see me, and they're like, oh my God, oh, you're here, I'm so excited. Like, I wanted that so bad. So that's what I looked up to. Like, that was the role model that I had. Unfortunately, my dad and I weren't as close as what, you know, we could have been. And then he ultimately passed away. But I like to think that maybe through some type of vessel, I'm taking on what he once was. And I'm just trying to live up to the high standard that he created, and the good role model that he was to me. So that's why I'm doing this. That's why I'm doing comedy. That's why I'm trying to bring joy and entertainment to people's lives, because that's what he did, and people liked him for that, and they respected him for that. So I'm just trying to keep up. You know, one person in particular that I know my dad really liked as a comic was Richard Pryor. And Richard Pryor, in my opinion, molded black comedy into, you know, what it would ultimately become today. But he was a real instigator as far as pushing the lines racially of, you know, is it acceptable to say this? Can you talk about that? And he just pushed it, and he made it fun. And because of that, I've been studying his works and what made him funny. And I've been trying to apply some of those same concepts into my own stand-up. I'm not in any way saying that I am as good as Richard Pryor or will ever be. I mean, I don't think anybody will ever be. But, you know, that's just one thing that I'm taking from the relationship that I have with my dad to try to bring into what I'm doing on stage. So I'm starting to introduce characters in my routines, my dad being one of them. And that's just another way that I'm trying to keep his memory alive, you know, share some of his stories that he had, that I remember from my childhood. And I don't just expect to see more of that in the future, because that's one of my favorite characters that I'm doing right now, is my dad. The audience seems to really like it, so we're gonna keep rolling with it. I gotta say one last thing. Comedy has been going so well since I've been taking it seriously, and I believe that, you know, my dad is playing a huge part in that. You know, even though he's not, you know, with us anymore, just his influence and what I can bring from our relationship, and just, I believe he's looking down on me just because the luck that I've been having, the breaks that I've been getting, the opportunities that I've been getting to perform in front of, you know, so many different people at so many different venues. I'm eternally grateful for everything that you've done for me, Dad. So thank you, and I hope that I'm making you proud as you look down. That's it for this week. Remember to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. We're going to be, I promise you, we're posting the Q&A video soon. It's been crazy. I've been traveling a lot during shows. I know I keep coming up with that excuse, but it's true. You know, if you don't know my schedule, it is on my Facebook page, which there will be a link to that in the description below, like there always is, as well as my Twitter account, where I post random pictures and, you know, stupid stuff that I'm thinking. But again, thank you for watching, and we will see you next week. Happy Father's Day.